Alright, here we are. Yeah, sorry about yesterday. I had to go all of a sudden.
Howdy. Feed a man for free, and he'll be back asking for more. Feed a man a bullet, you won't hear from him again. And I may have answers. I don't know how they do it. They're like saints, those followers. If they didn't charge for their services, I'd think they was crazy. But nah, they're just naive. Warms your heart. Couple of rad scorpions, those two. Gloria is the stable one, but she'd slit your throat if there's a prophet in it. Or rather, she'd tell her brother to do it for her. John Baptiste is one of the sicker humans I've had the displeasure of observing. What did you want to know? The only thing I know for certain is that I don't know nothing. Time you enjoy wasting isn't wasted time. Good? Bad? The guy with the gun makes the rules. See ya.
Thank you.
It looks like you took care of our short-term supply issues. And thanks, you can have a discount on medical services with me. Also, I would like to extend an invitation to join the followers of the Apocalypse. Your work here in the old Mormon fort has been invaluable, and I can't think of a more worthy recruit. Will you join us? Our aim is to gradually shape a better, brighter future for the Wasteland. We seek to heal the planet through efforts not unlike the medicine and education we offer here in the old Mormon fort. All we ask is members and those seeking aid do their best to help those in need when the opportunity arises. Excellent! The followers' mission will be better served with someone like yourself traveling around the Mojave. As a representative of the followers, I present you with your very own lab coat. Wear it well, and may it aid our cause. Also, before I forget, here's a key to a safe house you can use to rest if you happen to be in the area. I'll just mark it on your map. We're always looking for new members. Does he have any particular talent? Excellent. Ezekiel's been after me to find him a new assistant for ages. Tell the boy we'll take him. Good to hear. What do you have to donate? How much do you have to donate? Thanks. Thanks for the donation. Every bit goes toward helping Freeside. More than rough, it's a damn mess. Freeside townies are constantly picking fights with NCR civilians. Thugs and thieves are always looking for a victim, and the local families are just sitting back making caps on the mess. Freeside is in dire need, but no one has been man enough to step up. The followers can only do so much to stem the tide. There is always something needing done. A few souls here in Freeside could be great assets to the community, if they'd kick their addictions. We need a regular supply of medicine organized, but the Crimson Caravan wants too many caps for what we need. Lastly, tensions between the townies and NCR tourists have been going downhill fast lately. A lot of innocent people will get hurt if things blow up. Yes, old Bill Ronte and Jacob Hoff. They're not going to kick their habits on their own. Old Bill Ronte is an exceptionally skilled machinist. He could fix the problems we've been having with Freeside's water pump, if he sobered up. The Garretts hooked Jacob on chems when he was working for them. Ironic, since he used to homebrew detox chems. He's a natural chemist. In Freeside, the drunks and drug addicts flock in and around the Atomic Wrangler. I'd start there. Sobering them up and putting them back to work would go a long way toward helping Freeside. What do you want to talk about? The big man around here is the king. Not much happens in Freeside that he doesn't know about. He has the most influence locally, and some of his crew haven't helped the situation by harassing NCR citizens and charging double for water. Some NCR soldiers have been bringing in supplies, but none of it is going to Freeside locals. I've tried to speak to both sides to no avail. them at a discounted rate thanks to all the supplies you've donated. We're pretty short-handed as it is, but I suppose I could spare a few items. What did you want to know? Bill Bronte installed that pump a few years ago, back when he was sober. It was a major improvement for the community. But lately, the Kings have started charging locals to use it, and NCR squatters twice as much. That'll come to no good. They've been Freeside's gang for the past 5 years or so, ever since Mr. House and his three families pushed everyone else out of Vegas. They've done a lot of good for the community. But that seems to be changing. The flood of NCR squatters has been an affront to them. I guess that explains the situation with the water pump. Usually, the King wouldn't let his crew bully folks around like that. I know they sell a lot of guns, as if that's what Freeside needs. I hear Mick handles the guns. No idea what Ralph does. Oh, them. They sell energy weapons, which are very popular with better-heeled prospectors looking to explore the wastes. Stay clear of them. Brother and sister are both psychopaths, though at least Gloria is rational. Jean-Baptiste likes killing. A den of iniquity. The Garretts do more than their share to keep the locals drunk or high enough to stay lazy. They're thugs, on the other hand. They keep wired on chems to stay dangerous. What is it with Freeside and brother-sister psychopath teams? What did you want to know? The Old Mormon Fort serves as the regional hub for the followers of the Apocalypse. I am the administrator for this region. The followers of the Apocalypse aren't just interested in research. We care for our fellow man and do everything we can to help humanity. Here in Freeside, we provide food and medical services for those in need. We also have organized reconstruction efforts. With the help of Bill Bronte, we were able to install a water pump just west of here, but the Kings quickly took control of the pump. We arose from the boneyards of Adidam years ago. Since then, we have made it our mission to rebuild the wasteland and re-educate its inhabitants. We hope to forge a brave new world free of war and poverty by sharing knowledge and resources. Our primary goal is the free exchange of ideas. What?
You never would have escaped that gap.
Hey.
I can't ever thank
you
enough
so
for saving
much
me and mine.
I have no idea most of these people will survive without us.
What all is Eddie carrying right now?
Thank you for coming. Let's talk about that robot. I've heard through our channels that it has some research that may be related to Enclave and Poseidon energy technology. I'd like to get what I can from it and use that data for the good of humanity, all of humanity, unlike the Brotherhood. First, I'm going to pull off whatever log data I can. Then I'll use some of the tech around here to upgrade its weapon systems. Shouldn't be more than a few days' work. The Brotherhood is all about keeping technology to themselves and using what they find to protect themselves. They are isolationists and belligerent. I have no doubt that they plan to use the data for weapons research. There are plenty of people here to talk to you about us and our mission. Let's get to brass tacks and talk about that robot. Thank you. I'll get it back to you as soon as I can with the upgraded weapon systems.
What can I do for you? Yeah, and I... Thanks. Bye.
I guess ear update. I still can't hear out of my right ear. I need to go to the doctor's. I got insurance, but I don't have my card yet.
Welcome back. Good to see you again. Bye.
Yo, is it the gambling hour?
Howdy. Welcome to Vicky and Vance. How many chips would... Here's your chips. Play safe.
Okay. It likes to crash a lot in casinos when you gamble. So we're going to have to make tons of safety saves here. Dude, just one more and I'll make it back. I promise. Alright, it's the next one. The next one's gonna be the jackpot. Yeah, it's gotta all come back. It's cheap, and I know it's cheap, but we're going to go get the Naughty Nightwear. I got, dude, the fact that it's literally exponential every point of luck is insane. Dude, I always just mash through the dialogue in my own personal playthroughs. But because I want people to actually be able to watch this.
Welcome to Mick and Ralph's.
Yeah. And plus, I just like to hear it every now and then.
Another set.
I know Rodson talks super slow. I might end up not listening to all his stuff. All right, baby. Double down.
This is our first hot streak since we opened this place back up. Here's a little something on the house.
Oh, you're so nice.
You're doing great. Keep on spending money. Hopefully we'll get some extra action in here.
There we go, we got double down. What should the lucky number be? It's gonna be 22, because I'm a 22-year-old. Dude, it's all, we're gonna all or nothing until I'm out of chips. I wish there was a bet max on this one. That's so annoying to do. Come on. Whoops. Alright, we're gonna do this until I get the thing for doing a certain amount of games, right? Come on. This is it. It's worth it. Oh, it's gonna be next time. Come on. It's two numbers off. Come on. You know you want to.
Welcome to Vicky and Vance.
Yeah, okay. Well, what do you expect? It's a dirty little roadside hotel casino. They probably waited the roulette machine.
You're the luckiest player I've... Those fiend junkies over at...
You know what? I can't help it.
All three.
I want to win the jackpot. I never win the jackpot. You want to watch this? Watch. It's going to be 22. Okay. Whatever you say, I'm going for the jackpot. I want the jackpot so bad. Dude, if I get that jackpot, I'm gonna go like white boy monkey mode. Like Ryan Chongo show. Come on. Let's fucking go!
I've been taking some hits. I say kill them all. Sorry, you just win too much. We can't let you play here anymore.
Welcome to Vicky and Vance.
Look at that shit. Look at that. You got so much cats. Do we have any again? Yeah.
For the sky, lady.
Give me that gun.
Sorry, but I need to shoot Stacy. We can find you another gun. This is the best gun in the whole galaxy. I paid 1,000,000 caps for it, and it wasn't even brand new. Oh, man, it's Stacy's fault. She pretends like she didn't get hit. That's still a lot of money. I guess I'll take it. I don't really like to go to bed until it gets dark out. So long.
If you're looking for guns, talk to Mick. Otherwise, I've got a nice selection of general supplies. Take a gander. Son, I only offer services if the king gives the okay. Impress him and we can talk. All right. Yeah, I've got a little side business going. What I'm about to share with you does not leave this room, eh? Over the years, I've gradually perfected my craft to the point of perfection. No one can distinguish between my work and the real thing. What I'm referring to is passport. If you've got the caps, I can whip up a strip passport which will fool even the most well-trained eye. Hey, if you're interested and have the caps, they go for 500. Any less, and it ain't worth the risk of getting caught. What do you say? You game? No problem. If you need one later, just stop in. What do you want to know? If you haven't heard of the king, you must have been living under a rock or something. The king has his boys all over Freeside. He controls the water pump and is essentially the go-to guy for what goes around here. They are the local energy weapon dealers in Freeside. When it comes to lasers and plasma, they're the only game in town. They keep it that way. Gloria's men are the best armed in Freeside and ruthless to boot. But her brother, Jean-Baptiste Cutting, puts them all to shame. Their joint is the only place in Freeside to get it all under one roof. They've got gambling, booze, chems, and whores. They're good folks, just don't cross them. They're known for tidying up loose ends with a bullet to the brain box. Anything else I can help you with? Thanks for stopping in.
Welcome back. Things were better when the Omertas were buying, but we get by. Good selection from traders, and the Van Graffs keep things running. That's the thing. I have no idea. They just stopped buying guns all of a sudden. If you hear anything, let me know. Anything else I can help you with? Sure. Let's see what you've got. Why? Do you work for one of the casinos? In that case, yes, I do. Follow me. Like I always say, a polite society is an armed society.
You have Ken's, buddy? I could really use a fix. Julie's a saint, but I don't need help. I feel young and strong, as long as I get my Ken's. Why stop? I feel great. No worries. My guy will be here soon enough. Just wait. If I had two caps to scrape together, I'd buy the materials to make my own. My damn hands won't stop shaking. This guy named Dixon. Something about him seems sketchy, but I can't stop now. Last time I stopped, I felt like I was gonna turn inside out. At this point, I'm mostly buying his stuff just so I don't feel sick. Speaking of which, do you have any spare caps? Later. Evening. Looking for a fix, man? I got what you need. Have a look, baby. Another satisfied customer. Yeah, man. Those cats are out of their domes, addicted to my shit. They can't get enough. Pretty hilarious to watch. Those fools are from NCR. I love seeing those squatters in agony. We were doing just fine before those shits came here and made a mess of things. We don't need NCR eggheads wandering around confusing things. Really? Ah, you're such a saint. You know what? I might be willing to stop. There's something in it for me. Wait, man. You can't go around saying shit like that. Okay, I get your point. You won't have to worry about me supplying those two anymore. Come on back if you have any interesting news.
Hi.
So you're back. Got any chems for me yet? What? I need a fix now. Fine. If you really care so much, then give me some shots of Fixer to calm down these shakes. I'm gonna need at least 10 shots to get me through the week. From there, the followers should be able to help. I think you're right. I've been through worse. I'll go to the fort and see if the followers can watch over me while I recover. Buddy, spare a cap? I can make it worth your while. Ha ha ha! Oh, that's rich. You're not exactly my type. No offense. No, I meant I could give you a tip.
earn my money, so to speak. You look like you're new around here, so I'm sure I know all sorts of things you'd find useful. If not, well, it's only a cap. So what do you say? The first thing you should know is that Freeside is run by a pack of yahoos that call themselves the Kings. Their leader, who oddly enough calls himself the King, currently has his hands full trying to prevent an all-out riot in Freeside. That's two tips, but what the hell? You're a new customer, so the extra one's on me. Wanna hear another? Have you tried going to the Strip only to be stopped by those big metal murder machines? Happens every day around here. But if you know the right people, you can get through the gate without being a rich man. That one was pretty good, right? How about another? Northwest of the big Freeside sign is a casino called the Atomic Wrangler. It's not as fancy as the ones on the Strip, but there's still plenty of excitement to be found there. What do you say? Want another tip? There was a rumor a while back that the White Glove Society was really an all-ghoul gang, which is why they wear those weird masks of theirs. What do you think? Would I look good in a mask? Maybe I'd make more caps. I got more where that came from. Want another? People in Freeside generally fall into one of two categories. Those who've been here all their lives call themselves locals. When people from the NCR and other places started pouring in, the locals began referring to them as squatters, and the name stuck. The locals blame the squatters for the scarcity of resources in Freeside, and the squatters blame any act of violence against them on the locals. They're both right to some extent, and violent outbreaks between the two are all too common these days. What do you say? Want another tip? Caught a rumor the other day that some of the clientele over at the Wrangler have been making some rather strange requests. Stuff like weirdos wanting the services of ghouls and such. I almost have half a mind to volunteer myself, sexy beast that I am. That one was pretty good, right? How about another? The Strip is run by the three families who owe their allegiance to Mr. House. When he first showed up, he gave the local tribes the choice of working with him or getting the hell out of his way. Given how things turned out, I know which way I'd have gone. But hindsight's 20/20, right? That one was pretty good, right? How about another? East of Freeside, there's an old Air Force base, judging by the road signs. No one knows for sure what's in there, though, on account of anyone approaching the place getting violently blown up. What do you say? Want another tip? There's a rumor that a huge army is camped to the east, massing to attack the NCR. Like that had ever happened. Who in the world could stand up to the NCR and win? What do you say? Want another tip? I heard something about a town south of here being attacked, but details are sketchy. All I know is there haven't been any refugees showing up here, which means either the attack wasn't too bad, or it was very, very bad. I got more where that came from. Want another? Things have generally been bad here for the squatters, the people who came here hoping for a better life and just got stuck. But lately, the mood has changed. The squatters seem to be a bit more optimistic. I wonder what happened. I got more where that came from. Want another? The Omertas, one of Mr. House's three families, run a casino called Gomorrah on the Strip. If you thought the Wrangler was something, you owe it to yourself to go there. I got more where that came from. Want another? Traders have been griping for a while now about I-15 being too dangerous to travel. I'd steer clear of it unless you're armed to the teeth. That one was pretty good, right? How about another? The NCR used to run a prison to the southwest, but something happened a little while back,
And now all you'll get is hard looks if you ask about it. That one was pretty good, right? I probably don't have to tell you that Freeside's dangerous, but you might want to think twice about hiring one of those guards at the gates. They're not all saints, is all I'm saying. That one was pretty good, right? A traveler that passed through here not long ago told everyone he met that there's some kind of plant paradise to the west, where food is abundant. All the people foolish enough to listen to him and head out that way never came back. What do you say? There's a guy out on the main drag who sells secondhand adventuring gear. He's got an okay selection. But where does it come from? What do you say? Want another tip? Ever hear of the Gunrunners? They sell just about every kind of firearm you can imagine, and some you probably couldn't. That... he might not look it, but Ralph, or Mick and Ralph's, is no slouch with a keyboard. I've heard he's helped reprogram several robots in his time. That... I've heard people passing through mention some kind of underground fights pitting creatures of the waste against one another for sport. And when I say underground, that's their word I'm using, not my own. I got more where the chairman run a casino on the strip called The Tops. It's a pretty classy place by all reports. I haven't been there myself, but I hear security there is kind of tight. I got... at the northwest end of Fremont Street, you'll find the Silver Rush. It's run by a rather scary family called the Van Graffs. These are not people you want to mess with. But if lasers and such are your thing, the goods they sell are second to none. That... saw a strange thing the other day. The king took that robo-dog of his over to the old Mormon fort. Weird thing was that the dog was flipping out and had to be restrained by a few of the king's men. Hope he doesn't get loose. That one was... I've heard the Garretts over at the Atomic Wrangler are having a hard time collecting some money owed to them. An enterprising person like yourself might be able to make some caps helping them with their little problem. That... drugs are everywhere in Freeside, and even people you might not expect have become addicts. Jacob Hoff, for instance. That man was a brilliant chemist before he picked up the habit. Now, just another junkie. That King Pacer's a fan of Jet, too. Though I heard one of the followers talking about it being dangerous for him. Something about his heart. Do yourself a favor and stay away from that stuff, okay? That one... in the area between the north and east gates is the old Mormon fort, where the followers of the Apocalypse have set themselves up. The followers aren't a bad bunch, and provide healing and supplies to the people of Freeside as they can. What do you say? Mention the NCR and people around here get a little on edge. There's talk that they're going to take over all of New Vegas. It doesn't help that they've got military camps all over the place. And more troops pour into the area daily. What do you say? Want another tip? Have you been to Mick and Ralph's yet? They run a store just down the street and sell some things you might not expect. I got more where that... if you've been around the Kings, you may have met one of them named Pacer. He's always stomping around trying to show off his authority. Being new, you weren't around when it happened. But a few months ago, Pacer pissed off the Van Graff family big time. No one knows what went down, but word is the Van Graffs still want him dead. That one was pretty good, right? How about another? While everyone knows Mr. House runs New Vegas, no one knows the first thing about him. He just sort of showed up a few years back, and everything you see around you is the result. Just who in the hell is he? What do you... I understand. Well, have a good day.
Check it out, between the dumpsters there. What's your rush? The boys and I here want to get to know you better.
The king controls the water pump. If you want water, you need to pay like everyone else. If we let everyone run amok, the damn NCR would shut us down. Gotta have some way to regulate usage. Sure thing. Pleasure doing business. Bye.
Come on, man, I'm dying here. Julie? I love Julie. She's such a nice lady. One time I was working on the water pump, and she came over, put her hand on my shoulder, and told me I was doing a great job. Great job, she says. I just choked up and didn't say nothing. Compliments are so rare these days. What the hell? Why? I need alcohol, man. I'm gonna die if I don't get a drink. The only way you can help me now is a load of detox cams. At least a couple of doses of Fixer, a bottle of whiskey, and Radaway. I can take doses of Fixer and Radaway to gradually flush my system over time while drinking decreasing shots of diluted whiskey. This shit better be worth it, man. Oh, Julie, I've really screwed things up. I'll head over to the fort and get some rest. This has gone on too long.
I'm gonna have to search you. Then you're not gonna shop here. I'm afraid I'm gonna have to search.
Welcome to the Silver Rush, where only top-of-the-line energy weapons can be found. What can I do for you? Of course. Let's hit the road.
We'll do it when we come here for that.
Welcome to the Atomic Wrangler. What can I get you? Really now, this is news. We could possibly supply what they need, but they would need to supply us in kind. They have the tech know-how to make our stills work more efficiently. Pure alcohol means we can get our customers drunk quicker. Getting our customers drunk quicker means more caps spent at the tables and stuffing slots, if you know what I mean. Plus, the extra alcohol can serve as surgical disinfectant for their needs. The followers are a good lot. They've stitched up our boys in the past. Good. We can supply them with all the medex they need. For the fixer, we'll only be able to send over some basic drug components. We're not in the business of getting people off drugs, so we don't really dabble in that side of things. The followers should be able to whip some up with what we have available, though. They just need to agree to fix up our stills and keep them maintained, plus cover the cost for raw materials needed to make the alcohol. We ain't scraping to get by, if that's what you're asking. We've got the basics covered, but now you mention it, we have had unusual requests from some of our wealthier customers. If you can recruit escorts to match these customers' proclivities, I'd be willing to pay your finder's fees. Our wealthiest client has a thing for ghouls and a thing for cowboys. He wants an escort who can satisfy both fetishes. Plenty of customers have said they'd be willing to pay extra for a suave talker, someone who can fake the boyfriend experience real good. And then there's these disgusting robot fetishists you may have heard about. Well, those creeps want a sex bot. Have you ever run across a sex bot? Not that I'd ever want one within 100 feet of me, but I gotta be a businessman about it. Just don't rough up the merchandise before delivery. You break it, you bought it. Okay, you got yourself a deal. Find escorts to fill the positions, and I'll pay double. Just direct them to the Wrangler. I'll pay you when they show up. And the best place to start would be with Ralph, at Mickenralph's over on the east end of Freeside. Other than that, your guess is as good as mine. Sure, take a look. Give me a shout if you need anything else. For the right caps, I might be able to put in a good word and let people know you're not such a bad guy. What do you have in mind? Alright, I can chat you up, but it's gonna cost you. I'm not risking my reputation around here for nothing. Great. I'll let the townsfolk know you help old ladies across the street. And do your best to keep the town clean if you notice litter. That'll do nicely. I'll spin some stories about how you stopped a mugging or two and saved a kid's pet rat from certain doom. Great. This is gonna require an epic tale of heroism. I've got it. I'll say you slew a nest of deathclaws living in the sewers. It was bloody work, but you waded through the pack like a man possessed. Just to make this clear, I can only spin a whopper this big once. There's only so much people will believe before they see through the bullshit. Sorry, chum, but I've done all I can to chat you up to the locals. Yep.
Welcome to the Atomic Wrangler. What can I get you? We've got liquor, chems, and horrors aplenty. Pick your fix and we'll oblige. Our only rule is no sampling the merchandise. Caps paid in advance. If you'd like to do a bit of gambling, we have an exchange at the back of the casino on the left. I have some work I need handled. Back before we instituted the caps up front rule, we used to allow customers tabs. Well, needless to say, a few customers snuck out without paying their bills. We need someone to collect. The job would pay a percentage. If you bring all their debts back, we'll give you a cut of each. 25% is more than fair. It would add up to 150 caps if you bring them all in. All right. 50-50 it is, but you better bring back all of the caps. If we hear you crossed us, the next bounty hunter will be coming for you. Great. There are three people who need to be tracked down. A real mixed basket of fruits. Their names are Grex, Santiago, and Lady Jane. Grex is a bit cracked, but mostly harmless. Just don't mention anything about his lazy eye. He owes 138 caps and should still be around Freeside. Lady Jane fancies herself a high roller, but she's just another dirtbag NCR prospector. I'm not sure where to find her. I hear she's run goods for the followers of the apocalypse in the past, but other locals might know more. She owes us 250 caps. Santiago is a suave son of a bitch, but a total pansy when it comes to fisticuffs. He owes 212 caps and should be around Freeside as well. Anything else you need? Bye.
Shove off. You're making my luck turn bad. Fuck no! No matter what that old bitch McLafferty says, my dad said I could be in charge of the New Vegas branch. Besides, I got into a little money trouble with the Omertas. If I quit the Crimson Caravan, how am I supposed to get the money to gamble? One of the families that runs the strip. They're a pack of cheaters, but you still don't want to fuck with them. I wanted to be where the action is, so I got my dad to pull some strings and get me a cushy position with the Crimson Caravan. Everything was great until McLafferty came along. That old bitch is gonna hear about it from my dad, just you wait. What? No, wait! Look, I just need time. Don't rat me out to them. You want me to quit the Crimson Caravan? Fine, I quit. You can tell McLafferty that she won't see my face again.
Whoa, baby. Am I looking at a mirror? Or are you just that ugly? What? You mean you're not part of the act? Huh. Sorry. Thought you were the heckler Garrett hired to spice up the shows. Either you need to get your eyes checked, or that fame is fleeting thing is true. And since I happen to be world famous, you must be going blind. Name's Hadrian. Bet you never saw a ghoul in a suit before, huh? Of course, you don't exactly strike me as the worldly type. Yeesh, is my act that bad? Or are you just that dumb? Yeah, that's right. Got me a nice juicy contract with the management. Okay, I admit it. I ain't exactly rolling in caps here. But what do you want? I'm under contract. I can't get out. Yeah, go on. Scram.
Welcome to the Atomic Wrangler. Looking to exchange? Welcome to the Atomic Wrangler. Looking to exchange?
In what currency would you like your payout? Non-caps currencies will have fractions paid out in caps.
I don't think you can actually attack them on sight, but I'm not taking any chances.
Welcome back. Yes, I understand that he's decided to quit outright and not even ask for compensation. I'm a bit curious what exactly you said to him. Then again, perhaps I'd rather not know. Thank you all the same. I'm very happy to be rid of that man. Something has actually come up. A prospector recently came through here and spent a lot of caps on supplies. Closer inspection of these caps has revealed them to be brand new. This is a problem. The most likely source of these new caps is the old sarsaparilla bottling plant. Go there. Locate the bottle cap press and disable it. What would you like to know? People have been counterfeiting bottle caps forever, but it's always been small scale. A bottle cap press is a whole other threat. We can't have anyone devaluing our currency by mass producing new bottle caps. Certainly, bottle caps do wear out or get damaged. Some people even insist on using bottle caps in explosive devices for some reason. We make it a point to scour pre-war bottling plants and recover or disable the bottle cap presses. Seems we missed one. Lots of little things. The paint on the label, the machining, the type of metal it's made from. I know there's counterfeit caps floating around, of course. Fortunately, they're very time-consuming to make, so the numbers are small. It's been a pleasure.
Why am I carrying this so heavy? Oh, that's right.
Welcome back. Good. I'm sure you were thorough. Here's your payment for a job well done. It's been a pleasure.
Let's... already have that pig McCaffrey working for them. Do they need another guard? I've escorted my share of idiot tourists around Freeside. Too much trouble for what it pays. I'm all boot, knives, and leather, friend. And a ghoul besides. What kind of weirdo wants what I've got? Weirdos into bullwhips and necrosis, huh? Doesn't sound half bad. What am I thinking? I'm no whore. And I ain't about to hand my ass over to some penny ante hustler like he owns me.
I never noticed that if you do high times, you get an extra object. Extra option.
They do have a damn good selection of hooch over at the Wrangler. If I get to choose my customers, if I get to be a little rough with them, if my cut is fair, and if I get that discount, that just might work. Tell the Garretts I'll stop by to work out terms. Talk to you later.
Hey.
God, I wish that were me. Wait. Oh, okay, she's over here.
Welcome back, friend. That's phenomenal. Who did you find? They supply Freeside with drugs and liquor. From my point of view, they're just better organized pushers. Upgrading their stills would increase their supply of liquor and chems. How does that help Freeside? Good point. We wouldn't be paying anything for their supplies, just a portion of our food waste to make ethanol. We get food from nearby wasteland farmers in exchange for medical services, so we could put our caps back into helping Freeside. Tell the Garretts we'll keep their stills running if they provide us with supplies. Thank you for arranging this. You've been a godsend. I saw them. Thank you so much for helping them. This means a lot to the followers of the Apocalypse. You have our thanks. If you need some medical supplies, come see me. With Jacob working with us, we should be able to spare a stim or fixer once a day. Sure. Would you like a stim pack, fixer, or rat away? You'll need to wait another 24 hours for us to get more made. We need everything else we currently have. With your help, we now have a small overstock of fixer. However, it never hurts to have extra. How much do you have to donate? Thanks. Anything else? We don't have a lot right now, but this is what I can offer for sale.
What is it, fucking? Bitches won't even talk to you anymore, they just say. Where am I going now? What am I doing? I need to go get that book before I forget.
May I help you? I like to check up on things from time to time. I can't let this place fall apart now, can I? Since you're here, I can offer you some medical supplies. I can't give you everything I have, but I can give you a few things. I can give you stims or radiation supplies. Which would you prefer? Here you go. May I help you? I'm usually here a few days out of the week, mostly to keep the fridge stocked. Plus, it's nice to get away from it all every now and then.
She does a really good job at that. Aw, man. On some saves, whenever you go between them, they're infinite. It's really goofy. It's a shame it didn't happen on this one. Yeah, that seems worth it. Where are you, Eddie? You know what? I'm not using the YCS.
You today? Santiago is fabulous. Santiago does not owe anyone. Santiago is a Freeside VIP. Sir, Santiago does not know what he has done to offend, but he can explain everything. I didn't think she was upset enough to have me killed. Here are the capsail. I do the Santiago act to get out of paying for services every once in a while. I didn't think it could possibly get me killed. Later.
Caps. Whoa, yeah. I guess the carrot sent you after me. Look, I've got the caps right here. Just don't hurt me. Okay, here. That's everything I've got except the clothes on my back. I'm sorry about this. I won't. Thanks for not killing me.
Hey, you're the one who's been going around helping people around here, right? The king says to keep up the good work. Said to give you this.
Dude, it's fine to move this slow when you're like in areas of the game or like shit can happen at any moment. There's a little feeling a little bit of a drag here. I love the fucking goon squad that just follows me everywhere. Dude, I'm so sleepy. you.
Fully integrated security technotronic officer active and reporting for duty. Yes, ma'am. Vestal reporting for duty. Please assume the position. Servos active. Operation complete. Thank you for your business. Are you uncomfortable? My servos may require adjustment. Excellent. Awaiting further orders. Yes, ma'am.
Hey, you're the one who's been...
It's a race. I'm gonna win it. Sorry about that. I just get all Darwinistic at every opportunity.
What do we have here? Another petitioner for the king? Who's the king? You believe this asshole man? In Freeside, the kings rule. And the king rules the kings. Got it? Anything's possible, I suppose. How much is it worth to you to meet the big man? You know what? I like you. Half the people around here, they forget who runs this place. Head on through. King's the bored-looking guy by the stage. Can't fucking miss him.
Look, Rexy, someone new's come to see us. Poor boy. He hasn't been feeling well lately. I'm the king. What can I do for you?
Charge? Pace must be at it again. What did he take you for? Pace must be losing his touch. Either that, or you're a smooth one. So, what can I do for you? Maybe so. Maybe so. You look like you might be able to handle yourself. Tell you what, you do me a favor, and I'll have some more work for you when it's done. Sound good? I'll start you off with something easy. Did you notice the bodyguards for hire near the gates when you entered Freeside? It's good money if you can stay alive long enough. Freeside's not as safe as it used to be, so the money is well earned.
Usually well-earned, that is. Recently, my man told me that one of those bodyguards, a fella named Oris, is making a little too much money. He's making a killing in repeat business. Once someone hires him, they never want anyone else. I want you to find out why. Specifically, I want you to hire him. Play the part of an innocent tourist and follow his lead. If nothing happens, so be it. But I'm guessing things won't go so smoothly. Call it a hunch. So, what do you say? You may have noticed that some of those guards out there are kings, too. I'm just looking out for my men. I'm not trying to get some kind of unfair advantage. I just want a level playing field for my boys. So, what do you say? I've tried, but he can smell a king a mile away. Probably knows all our faces by now. He's not a stupid man, I'll give him that. What I need is someone he won't recognize, which makes you perfect. So are you gonna take the job or what? Okay then, once you part ways, return here. I look forward to hearing your report. Oh, and take this to cover the hiring cost.
We'll do that in a bit. We'll do that in a bit, innit?
Freeside, so here's a little advice, friend. Don't go past the Southgate greeter without talking to it first. Those bots are programmed to vaporize anyone who enters the fenced-in area without authorization from the greeter. The name's Old Ben. I've been living in Freeside since the day I was born. I've done a bit of everything around here. Courier, butcher, crier, escort, gun for hire. Some of which I'm not proud of, but I do my best to help around town when needed. Exactly one of the reasons I got out of that job. Too many shifty characters looking to have someone else move their hot items. My father ran a butcher shop here in town, but business went downhill when another vendor started selling this strange meat at half our prices. You're telling me, not long after my father's shop went under and he passed away from the loss, people around town started experiencing shakes. No one gets shakes like that unless they're eating human flesh. But no one would believe me. The sick bastard gradually went insane and passed away. Wasn't long before someone moved into the guy's place and found half-buried human remains in the crawl space. I didn't bother saying, "Told you so." After a while, I made enough money to get a passport into Vegas. Back then, you could get approved for entry for a fraction of what it costs now. Well, I got a job working as a crier outside of the Tops, advertising for the local talent performing at the casino. That didn't last long. Well, being a suave young guy, I chatted up the ladies from time to time, and one of the manager's girls started to take a liking to me. I never touched the woman, but the jealous prick decided it was my time to go. He framed me by saying I'd stolen from the casino. Sure enough, a few grand was missing from the casino vault. I have to assume the bastard stole the funds and figured I was a convenient fall guy. Yeah, but what can you do? I was stripped of my casino apartment and all of my belongings and booted back into Freeside. From there, I didn't have a lot of career options, as my rep was destroyed. So the escort job sort of fell into my lap. No pun intended. Well, I suppose you could look at it that way, but I was packing a whole different kind of heat. No. Escort just sounds better than man whore. Yep. I was damn good at my job, too. But after a while, I just felt like a piece of meat and had to quit. When I quit the escort job, I had enough money to buy a pistol belt and some other gear. Bodyguards make a good, honest living, and I had the wits and physical build to handle most thugs. After saving a few tourists from trouble, I got a reputation for being a stand-up guy again. And after a decade, managed to save up enough to retire. All right. I'm retired, but life has been a bit dull without some kind of action. What's the job? Ah, I get you. So you think because of my past escort work, I'd be interested in that kind of thing. I got out of that work because it just made me feel empty inside. What makes you think I would ever go back to that degradation? You know what? You're right. I looked at the whole thing from the wrong angle. I suppose I could be a loving muse to some, while simply relieve stress and tension in others. Thanks for that insight. Tell Garrett I'd be happy to start at the Wrangler immediately. This should be a nice change of pace from retirement.
I like old Ben. He's like the Uncle Ben to our courier. Get dunked on.
Submit to a credit check, or present your passport before proceeding to the gate. Trespassers will be shot.
Let me pass, robot.
Thank you, madam. You may proceed.
What's our perception?
Hello. Lovely to meet you. In that case, I suppose you're here to collect. I apologize, but I simply do not have enough caps on me to cover the debt. If someone were to recover my caravan from that cave, I could easily pay in full. But who would bother with such a mess? Damn! I didn't want to hand over all of my caps because I won't have enough to get home to California. Here, take it off. I'll find my way home one way or another.
Wait, what are we doing? Dude, I'm messed up. I keep taking melatonin to fall asleep because I've got problems with my ears. And then I wake up extraordinarily tired. Okay, so we're going to the Wrangler.
Those lumps of human refuse, but you got the job done. We need you to hunt down another person. That son of a bitch McCaffrey stole a ton of caps and ran off to Vegas. I guess the fact that we farmed out his usual word to you pissed him off. No one steals from the Garrett twins. If you can kill that bastard and bring back as much as you can, you'll be paid very well. See the king. I'm sure he could work something out to get you in. You'll need to prove you're worth his time, but it'll be well worth it.
Howdy.
Welcome back, friend. What can I get you? Imagine that. What's his name and when's he start? A she, huh? Well, I guess the customer who made that request can't get everything he wants. Hell, who knows? You might not even notice the difference. And who would that be? I've heard some stories of that old guy. I'm amazed he's still alive with how much he's been through. If the stories are true, it'll be a valuable commodity here at the Wrangler. I appreciate the find.
You did? Ha, damn! I've been looking for one of those for years. For my customers, I mean, I'm not into that kind of shit. Hey, I'm amazed you even found the thing in the first place. Here is double for your trouble. Those freaky fetishists ought to be satisfied now. It is! It will? My God, imagine the possibilities. It didn't happen to come with an owner's manual, did it? Ah, forget it. Trial and error should do it. Hey, that's great. We'll get some supplies sent over today as a show of good faith.
Once our stills are upgraded, we'll never be short on liquor for our patrons. If Jacob Hoff is sober, we might even have a few new drinks on tap. Most might view us as drug-dealing enablers around here. But honestly, we care about our patrons. It's bad business for people to get addicted. We've got enough crime in Freeside without a bunch of strung-out junkies robbing traders and gamblers to afford their next fix. House may have boxed us out of the strip, but we also don't have to deal with their bullshit. I think now that the followers are working with us, we'll be able to shape up Freeside a bit more.
Yep.
A super mutant in Freeside?
If you need to cross Freeside, no one will keep you safer than I will. Just look around. People here are as like to stab you as say hello. That is, if I weren't at your side. 200 caps gets you my watchful eye for a trip to the South Gate. Sorry, but all the people with real money are heading for the Strip, so that's the way I go. You want to go somewhere else? Hire one of these losers. We'll be heading down the main street here the whole way down. No detours. You go off sightseeing, and I go off to find another customer. I'll keep a brisk pace, so try not to fall behind. Now let's head out.
Hey, you're the one who's been going around helping people around here, right? The kid...
To your left here is the old Mormon fort. You get roughed up, the followers there will patch you right up.
Not that I ever knew their services.
Up ahead on the next block is where the
kids have. We've got stuff we're not even allowed to sell, people.
They don't outnumber you 5-1. Down to the right here is the fun part of town. You haven't seen Freeside till you've been to the Wrangler. Hey, slow down. I don't like the look of some of those men ahead. Let's take a different way around.
Ooh, get him.
Where you going, buddy?
Nothing to worry about. If you had hired one of those other hacks, you'd be up to your ass in lowlife right about now. imagining things. It's just the rush of adrenaline caused by your near brush with death. Luckily for you, I was here, so there's no reason to get out of Call it a hunch. You do this job for long enough, and you learn to trust your instincts. Don't distract me. I need to focus.
I get that they were really strapped for time, and that's why they had to divide the strip in Freeside. But I still feel like the better choice would have been to make the fast travel points, the Mormon Fort, the King's School, Lucky 38 Tops, and the Embassy, right? Instead of the three gates.
Word is the leader of the food.
I don't know. That's just me, though.
What do you have for me?
Ah, so it went down like that, huh? I guess it can't be helped now. Well, you're not subtle, but you get the job done. That's good enough for me. Maybe you can help me with something more important. A lot of folks around these parts who've been here a while resent the sheer number of people that have come into the area since the strip was built. In turn, the newcomers, most of whom come from the NCR, have gotten ornery from being resented. Sometimes things get violent. This is one of those occasions. Recently, a few friends of mine were attacked, and I want you to find out who did it. Word's come that they just woke up over at the old Mormon fort just north of here. Head on over, see if they remember anything. Good. I like that enthusiasm. Return when you have some information we can use.
What is it? Can't you see I want to be left alone with my friend here? Oh, that's different then. How can I help? I'll do anything to get the bastards that did this. Well, it happened at night, around 11. We'd recently made some caps off a bit of scrap we found and wanted to invest in wisely. As we were leaving the Wrangler, we must have taken a wrong turn and ended up in the squatter side of town. From out of nowhere, these big guys show up and start barking questions at us, wanting to know if we were locals. The kid there is about as proud as a local around here gets, and started yelling back at him. Then all hell broke loose. Kid got the worst of it, sad to say. They were big guys, young too, no old geezers like me. Hell, none of them looked even half my age. I was mostly face down in the dirt, begging for my life when it happened, so I only got a quick look at them. I hope you find the bastards that did this. If you want, try asking my friend Wayne over there about him. He saw more than I did.
Wayne?
Bruce?
Hey.
Bruce Wayne?
That true? Did the king really send you? I don't really know what else I can add. There were a bunch of guys, better dressed than most Freesiders, I guess. That help? Sorry I couldn't help more, especially since you're being so nice. Hey, wait, I just remembered something. I might have heard one of the guys that attacked us call another by name. We had just about had it when one of them said, "Hey, Lou, we gotta go." At least I think he said Lou. It might have been something else. Now that I think of it, he said Lou something, something with a T. Tenant, that's what he called him. Lou Tenant.
Wait. The boy means well, but he's dumb as a mute sometimes.
Hey. Great to see you again. I'm honestly pleasantly surprised they would help us out. But I can see the Garretts aren't doing this out of the goodness of their hearts. Well, it looks like you've earned yourself a discount on supplies now that we'll be fully covered. This supply deal will aid our work immensely. Sure. Would you like a stim pack, fixer, or Rataway?
Have you found anything out, or were you just here to chat? Bunch of soldier boys, huh? They usually don't come around these parts since their big base is on the other side of the strip. If they're coming over here now, it's gotta be for a reason. I didn't want to believe the rumors that they're looking to take over Vegas, but now, if something big is going down, I'm sure rumors of it will have spread. Ask around, particularly in the squatter areas where the NCR folk hang. You might also mosey on over to the Mormon fort and chat Julie Farkas up. The followers tend to be in the know about these things. Just don't ask her what to do about it. She'll probably ask you to hug someone or something.
I still think my favorite one is Shinji. Crank that, soldier boy. Fuck you. What's that phone number in call kiss me through the phone? I remember that it was already me. Dude, my eyes are so tired. It's like hurting my eyes to look at
the
screen
back,
right now.
Friend. Only a little. A friend of mine, Major Elizabeth Kieran, has been handing out supplies to the poor a little west of here. What about it? I know something's got them riled up, but I've been too busy with other matters to really look into it. If you're looking into the matter, talk to Elizabeth. She's in charge of the operations here in Freeside, though she won't open up to you right away. If Elizabeth holds out on you, tell her that I sent you. She should be a little more forthcoming if you mention my name. Was there anything else you wanted to talk about?
That's it. It's... Ain't me. You wanna date me. But I can't right now, so kiss me through the phone. Kiss me through the phone. I'll see you later on. Dude, if I could fucking play licensed music during this shit, we would be jamming to some Brockhampton right now. There's so many good songs. So what I've been doing this entire time, because I can't play copyrighted music on recordings that go up. And the thing is like, I don't even care about the monetization or anything like that. I don't make money off these. But I literally just can't play it. Wait, where am I going? That's right, this time. But I just want to play it. Like, I don't want to make money off of it. I just want to be able to play it.
Hold on. What's the password?
See, this game gets it right.
It does.
Like, the white dude doesn't...
Hold up. What's the password? I guess you're not getting in here then, are you? Hold up. What's the password? If you're here to see the major, then I suppose it's all right. Head on through.
See? The white guy's stupid enough to be lied to.
Here you go. I hope this helps. Welcome. There's food and water here for any citizen of the NCR. Please, have some. Yes. I'm a major in the Supply Corps, which is where this food and water comes from. No, I'm afraid we don't. Don't you have a friend you wanted to bring in? That's not really a pleasant topic of conversation. Let's just say we have our reasons. You know Julie? Not everyone in the NCR sees eye to eye with the followers, but they're okay in my book, mostly because of her. If you really want to know, we sent an envoy to the king, offering to coordinate the relief effort. In a manner of speaking, our envoy was brutally beaten and only barely survived. My superiors ordered the relief mission scrapped. I managed to get clearance to carry out the mission anyway, but with greatly reduced support. Now, there's not enough supplies to go around, even if I wanted to serve the rest of Freeside, which I don't. That's all in the past now. I should get back to work. Say hi to Julie for me.
Dude, my jaw's getting fucking sore from yawning. I think I'm also sleepy because I keep yawning trying to make my ear pop.
Hey there. I heard that NCR soldier lady told you some wild story about them sending a messenger to us to work out some deal. That's bullshit, and it's nothing to bother the king with. More like they sent someone to spy on us and he wasn't tough enough to last in Freeside. So do everyone a favor and keep your mouth shut about it, okay? You're a bastard after my own heart. Here, this should do it. Fine, here's some more. But you better keep your mouth shut. I'm out of here. Got some important business to take care of.
Now we are doing Mr. House. So we actually are about to go murder that NCR group. This shouldn't be a big deal, because I'm idolized. And as long as you don't kill any of them yourself, your reputation will only drop to good-natured rascal. Good-natured rascal doesn't lock you out of anything. Not to mention, we get Ambassador Crocker's note in like 20 minutes anyways, so I don't think it matters.
You find out something about them soldier boys yet?
Can't get over how that sounds.
Handing out supplies? Like food and stuff? That ain't nothing to get ruffled over. You find anything else? Ah, that would explain the goons. They're here to keep people like my friends away from the food. That ain't something I support. No, sir.
That's not after Ashley.
Don't worry. I'm not gonna do anything uncalled for.
I'm gonna see that those supplies are distributed a little more. What the hell?
King, we've got problems.
Lay it on me. What's going on?
There's a shootout going down near the train station. It's Pacer and some strangers. Might be NCR.
I want you to back him up. See this through, and there'll be something good waiting for you when you get back.
Hey.
You want someone dead?
Good, you're here. These soldier boys don't kid around. They must have had a lookout posted and spotted us coming. They took out two of my guys right away, and now the rest are too scared to move in. That leaves you. You're a bastard after my own heart. Here, it's all I got. Now get in there and waste those guys!
Oh, yeah, they don't talk. Okay. Ooh, whoopsie. Guess it wasn't enough to drop me at all. Any of the keys. Look at this. Look at how cool I look.
I was drawing their fire. Otherwise, you would have been chewed up. I sent one of my guys back to the king to report what happened. You should head back. He'll probably want to thank you.
I've already heard all about what happened, and all I can say is that I and all of Freeside thank you. Thank you very much. You've helped us plenty, so I'll tell you what. Just this once, name whatever you want, and if I can make it happen, it's done. Don't rush it, though. Toss it around in your head a little. You only get one favor from the king. Things have been a lot better since you helped with those soldier boys. Thanks again. So, what can I do for you? What about him? He's been acting peculiar for some time now. I took him to the followers and had him checked out, and they said his brain is bad or something. No, they said they don't have the tools to help him. For now, but they said eventually he's gonna get worse. I don't know what to do. I don't know. Maybe if you found a way to help my poor Rex here, I'd be much obliged. Your best bet will be to talk to Julie Farkas over at the old Mormon Fort north of here. Maybe you'll have better luck than I did. We're different than other gangs, not just because we dress better. We're not just a group of thugs looking for our next fight. The Kings are about an idea, you see, where every man is free to follow his own path, do his own thing, where every man is a king in his own right. Whoa there. Not just anyone can be a king. First of all, we usually only accept people native to the area. Second, I have to approve, and I don't. You haven't shown me you've got what it takes to be a king yet. But if you're fixing to join something fierce, stick around. If you play your cards right, things might change. We've tried to pass our philosophy on to the people of Freeside, but not everyone is ready to be a king. The kids love us, but the old-timers tend to shy away and keep to themselves, and they probably couldn't pull off the look anyway. As for the others, some people just plain don't respect others, and that's a no-no. If there's one thing I won't tolerate, it's lack of respect. Sure thing. What you have in mind? To understand Freeside, you have to look back a few years. Originally, we were all just tribes making a living in this area. That all changed when Mr. House came around. He made an offer to the three biggest tribes that were willing to listen to him. Today, everyone calls those tribes the Three Families, and they live in luxury and run their own casinos in the Strip. The rest of us were left to fight over the crumbs, living in the shadow of those more fortunate. Things got pretty nasty for a while, but we wanted more, a place of our own, a place where no one could tell us what to do, and we didn't want to go elsewhere to find it. So we took control of this place and made it our own. That's really all Freeside is, the best of a bad situation. Near as I can tell, it's some sort of religious institution. Oh, I know it says school out front, but everything in here seems to be related to the worship of some guy from back in the day. People used to come here to learn about him, to dress like him, move like him, to be him. If that's not worship, I don't know what is. Not a whole lot to tell. There were only a few books left in here when we found it, and those were rotted away. There were some posters left that were pretty well preserved, which is how we know all this stuff was based on the same guy. The thing of it is, we don't even know what his name was. All the posters just referred to him as the King. Well, that and the giant sign outside. This place could have been the King's House of Dogchow, and I still would have taken the name. But I like to think I keep the memory alive. As far as we can tell, the guy that built this place was considered the coolest of the cool, and taught other people how to be more like him. People would come all around to learn how to sing, dance, dress, and even speak the way he did. Something like that, yeah. There were some working tapes here when we first got here, so we know what he sounded like. Sadly, they stopped working a few years back, so I sold them to a junk merchant who was passing through. Otherwise, I'd play some for you. All the outfits you see my guys wearing around were originally found in here, too, along with more hair gel than you can shake a stick at. Ask away. Normally, we don't let outsiders join, and you'd be the first female king ever. But I think I can make an exception in your case. From this day forward, you're one of us, and no one in Freeside will mess with you if they know what's good for them. In addition, if you want to do something about that hair of yours, talk to Sergio. I'll let him know you're coming. Perhaps more importantly, you've earned the right to wear something a little more stylish. Here, wear it proudly.
Look at this shit. I'm rocking it.
Things have been a lot better since you helped with those soldier boys. Pace? He and I grew up together around here. We've been through a lot together. There's no man I'd rather have at my side in a pinch. Don't judge him too harshly for trying to get some caps out of you. He probably took you for a squatter, looking for a place to settle down. There have been a lot of people moving into the area lately. It's got some people riled. Can't blame them myself. There's only so much to go around. There's me, but I don't really like talking about myself. There's Julie Farkas and the other followers down at the old Mormon fort. The Garrett twins up at the Wrangler deserve mention. Wouldn't be right not mentioning the Van Graffs, I suppose. And while they're not important in the overall scheme of things, there's Mick and Ralph, too. Just don't tell them I said that. Who all did you want to know about? Julie represents the followers of the Apocalypse. They're a group that tries to help people out whenever they can, so we get along just fine. If you ever need to get patched up, one of their docks will have you right as rain in no time flat. They sell supplies, too, or used to. Heard they were having trouble bringing stuff in or keeping up with the demand or something lately. Did you want to know about anyone else? Them twins run the Atomic Wrangler, the only working casino here in Freeside. It's become pretty much the place to go around these parts. Give it a whirl when you've got some time. Now, was there anyone else you wanted to know about? They're a family-run business from out west that deal in weapons, mostly. A word of caution, though, they're not a friendly bunch. Not at all. Their store is just past the Wrangler and sells all kinds of fancy weapons that most people around here can't afford. Anyone else you wanted to know about? Mick and Ralph sell all sorts of things at a small store over by the East Gate. They've done all right by us, and they'll do all right by you. You want to know about anyone else? All right. I'll see you later.
Welcome back, friend. Rex, it breaks my heart every time I see him. He's such a good dog. Yes, a few months ago, we had to tell him there was nothing we could do. No, Rex's condition is way beyond anything we can handle. He requires brain surgery and some sophisticated cybernetics work, too. There's an old scientist named Dr. Henry, who reportedly specializes in this sort of procedure. He'd probably be your best bet. Last I heard, he was living up in Jacobstown, far to the northwest. No problem. Here is what we have available.
Oh, I hate going all the way up to this fucking building.
Things have been a lot better since you helped with those soldier boys. Thanks again. So, what can I do for you? She said, what? Why didn't you just say so when I was there? Actually, come to think of it, I was pretty angry when I went down there. I vaguely recall something about upending a few tables, maybe knocking out one of her doctors. Anyway, that's incredible news. Only thing is, there's too much going on around here for me to make a trip like that. And I need all of my guys to keep things settled here. You seem to be awfully interested in my boy Rex here, and you've done some good work for me already. I'll tell you what, you promised to get Rexy here to that doctor, and I'll lend him to you. What do you say? I can't thank you enough.
Now, there's a few things you should know about old Rex here if you're going to be traveling together. First, he hates rats. Can't stand the things. Giant rats, mole rats, doesn't matter. He catches a whiff of one, and he's off like a shot after him. He's normally pretty obedient, but you might have to chase him some if he goes after one of the little varmints. Second, he doesn't like hats or the people wearing them. Don't ask. I have no idea why. Maybe because it rhymes with rats. That should be it, though. Other than the occasional bad spot when his brain starts hurting him, that is. But I'm hoping you'll see to that. I wish you both luck. Take care of my Rex now, you hear? Rex, this is your new master. Protect her as you would me.
Bother someone else.
Is there something else I can do for you? This neural degradation. Biomed gel can only preserve a living brain for so long, so you'll need to find a replacement. I haven't left Jacobstown in years, but there was one woman in Novak. Gibson. I remember her living with a pack of hounds. Aside from her, I know that the Fiends and Caesar's Legion fight alongside dogs. There could be viable specimens among them, if you can get to them. Promising, but I won't be able to synthesize the drug anytime soon.
Hello. Hey there. Pleasure doing business with you. Bye. So, you're back. Now, where do we leave off? Dr. Henry? Now, there's a name I haven't heard in years. Hard to believe he's still alive.
As for your request, it's a bit ghoulish if you ask me, but Ray is pretty old, and I'll probably have to put him down soon enough. As for the price for this favor, 700 caps sounds about right. Ray's like family, and I've got other dogs to take care of. Fair enough. Here, Ray, Mama's got something for you.
Oh.
Sure, just come treat me like a pack Brahmin, okay?
So, you're back. Take care now.
Ice cream.
Let's see. You're making me carry the heavy stuff, aren't you?
Is there something else I can do for you? Very well. Show me what you've brought so that I can analyze its potential. All right, let's see here. Neural pathways look good. Definitely a breed of guard dog. If I transplant this brain into Rex, he'll be a bit more ferocious in his attacks. Have a seat. This will take a while.
Dude, look at this absolute squad. I think that's literally everyone, right? Head to the script. All right, now I'm going to save here. That way, in case it auto plays anyways, I can edit this part out of